From the Home Slice News Center, this is the Daily Slice for Thursday, April 13th, 2023. I'm D. Ray Knight. This is what's going on. Rapid City Police have apprehended a suspect wanted in connection with a March shooting. Seton Long Soldier, 18, has been taken into custody in connection with the shooting that occurred March 19th that left one person injured outside a business on North La Crosse Street. Long Soldier was identified as the shooter during the investigation, and a warrant was obtained for his arrest. Police found Long Soldier on April 7th. Long Soldier is being held without bond in the Paynton County Jail. He is charged with aggravated assault, attempted robbery, and several other crimes. He's due in court later this month. The RCPD has released their March crime report. Amy Rose has the details.
Rapid City Police have released their March crime report, where there were 434 crimes reported, with thefts and assaults making up just over half of the reports. March thefts totaled 119, while assaults totaled 114. Next highest crime was motor vehicle thefts at 30, and drugs or narcotics violations totaling 27. Vandalism incidents at 26 rounded out the top five. Of the total 434 crimes reported, 157 of those were reported between the hours of 12:01 a.m. and noon, while 277 of the total 434 crimes were reported between 12:01 p.m. and midnight.
Every year, police chiefs and sheriffs come together for the annual South Dakota Sheriffs and Police Chiefs Association Spring Conference to discuss relevant issues in their communities and share information and related experiences with others. This year in Deadwood, the main focus was on border issues related to immigration and illegal drugs in their communities. Paynton County Sheriff Brian Mueller and Meade County Sheriff Pat West were among those attending. South Dakota Senator John Thune was also on hand to discuss his experiences visiting the southern border. In national and international news, U.S. consumer inflation eased in March, with less expensive gas and food providing some relief to households that have struggled under the weight of surging prices. Yet prices are still rising fast enough to keep the Federal Reserve on track to raise interest rates at least once more in May. Consumer prices rose just 0.1% from February to March, down from 0.4% from January to February, and the smallest increase since December. Measured from a year earlier, prices were up just 5% in March, down sharply from February's 6% year-over-year increase, and the smallest such rise in nearly 2 years. Expecting a tax refund? Well, it could be smaller this year. Amy Rose has the story.
If you're expecting a tax refund, it could be smaller than last year. And with inflation still high, that money won't go as far as it did a year ago. The 90 million taxpayers who have filed as of March 31st got refunds that were an average of nearly 10% less than last year. That's in part due to pandemic relief programs expiring. The filing deadline for most taxpayers is Tuesday. And according to the most recent IRS data, the average refund is $2,910, down from $3,226. That's a difference of more than $300.
Ukraine's leaders say they don't see a major U.S. intelligence leak as gravely damaging future offensives. A key reason? They have long held back on sharing their most sensitive operational information, doubting Washington's ability to keep their secrets safe. Ukrainian and U.S. officials said this week that only Ukrainians know some battle plans and other operational information, not the Americans. That means the leak of secret military documents, including some assessing Ukraine's battlefield strengths and weaknesses against Russia, likely has not been enough so far to change the course of the war. Your weather forecast from the Home Slice Weather Center. Increasing cloudiness and a high of 65. Low tonight, 37. And that was your Daily Slice for Thursday, April 13th, 2023. The Daily Slice is a production of Home Slice Media Group, hosted by D. Ray Knight with Amy Rose. Executive producer Mark Houston. Engineered by Chris Jacquez. I'm D. Ray Knight. Have a great day.